Do you recall what we were talking earlier about the Armstrong's army in the build-up to that? Do you remember the scene where Bullet Bob is training the rock and roll and the Armstrong boys
In the woods.
in the, well, as he said, in the jungles of Africa, or
Yeah, no,
as Dutch said,
no,
Dutch said that, I'm sorry.
it was the jungles of Guatemala, wasn't it? I don't know, but you know where that was, don't you?
I'm sure it was your property of some sort
That was
where.
my backyard in Morristown.
That's what I figured. That's what I figured. I was going to ask you that.
I loved my backyard in Morristown. On the side of me, there was no house to the right of me. It was all woods up to the, and I lived off a little road, side road. So it was all woods to the right of me, and to the back of me was the Panther Creek State Park. So the Dirty White Boy video where he was in Central Park, that was my backyard.
Yes.
I think Tammy was in my Sonny was in my backyard at some point. And or possibly I was in her backyard. No, hey, boy, hey. And Armstrong's Army, the training video, that was back there. And we were, oh my God, it was fucking hilarious. But we were, just making that. We came out and said we're gonna do a training video. And I talked to Bob for a little while. He made a bunch of shit up, and off we went, and we shot it.
It was pretty good. Ricky and Robert have their camouflage and their faces painted. So, pretty intense training video. Armstrong's army was out there
And they
making
got
sure
the
they were getting
picture of
ready.
us, and Bob's got the chain. He puts the picture on the chain on the tree, and he beats it into pieces with the chain and the barks flying and everything. And then we did the Allman Brothers video or audio. Shit, I'll try this again. The video montage to the Allman Brothers music. And that cost basically. I gave the camera guy $75 to come out that day, and we shot it before a show in Morristown where they were already in town. So it cost us $75 to, promote the fucking deal for 3 minutes on TV.
Crazy man, that was it. So let me guess, Kevin Sullivan's when he was first the master, those were filmed in the same spot when he's filming it at nighttime. Did you tell me that? I couldn't
Actually,
remember.
no, that was out near Brian Hildebrand's, I think, because
Okay.
I didn't want to build a fire in my backyard. I think I'm going to say that Brian found that, because Brian was Renfield, the one that fell out of the tree.
That's Brian Hildebrand?
That's Hildebrand. Yes, that's
I had
Hildebrand.
no idea that was
Oh
Hildebrand.
yes, so I had him. He was the producer for the location and everything for that, and he led us to it, and we had the whole thing, and yeah, and he was Renfield.
So he's the one that's in the video going, yeah, master, master. That's Brian Hildebrand the whole time? I didn't know. Ah, shit.
An uncredited appearance by a guy who would later become a WCW superstar.
I'll be damned. I'll be damned. Oh boy. Smoking Mountain's been so much fun. So we're up to, like I said,
And when once again, I don't mean to cut you off, but once again, we had Kevin Sullivan, we had Brian Clark, who's Night Stalker, Hildebrand was Renfield, who was the other heel in that? Was that it wasn't a Mongolian Mauler, was it? Was it oh goddamn,
For a
was
time,
it the Mauler?
for a
But
short
no, I mean
period.
in that video where he fell out of the
No,
tree.
I think the video was just Kevin Sullivan, Night Stalker, and Hildebrand falling out the
Okay,
tree.
and
I think it
that's
was
why,
just them three.
because two oddities looked fucking sparse. So Hildebrand, on the spur of the moment, that's when he got that cowl and he became the third oddity, just so that it would be a group. But anyway, once again, we did it before a show, and we had an idea of obviously what we want to talk about. And Kevin Sullivan knows how to cut a promo, so we just told him, and it cost $50 to shoot something. Now they'd have a goddamn production team. And fucking writers would be polishing the script, and the talent would be studying whatever the fuck.
Studying your script, yep.
The gangsters in the graveyard. That's probably my favorite of actually, just because it was fucking funny. But we went out with a high-8 camera. I didn't even hire. I was the cameraman. I didn't even hire a god. I could be seen with the gangsters in because we were in the graveyard. Nobody was there. Was going to talk, right?
Right.
So we go out there with the high 8 millimeter fucking camera, D-Lo, Mustafa, New Jack, and my girlfriend at the time, Heather, and her cat. And we found the cemetery, and we went in, we made up the promo, and I kind of knew what shots I want to have. And since the cat wouldn't cooperate, I do the camera jiggle, and then we shoot the black cat coming out from behind that scared him away. And we just edited it in post and put Don't Fear the Reaper on the end of it. And for fucking an hour's worth of time, we had, and I did, I actually edited the Undertaker music video myself on the offline from the WWF footage they sent me. So it, you know, we had 4 minutes, 5 minutes of fucking TV promoting a couple of big weekend main events. It didn't cost anything. And it's not that fucking hard either. If you have people that know what they're doing and people that know how to talk and get themselves over.
Yeah, it's amazing what you can do with people who don't need a script to cut a promo. Because, I mean, you see some of the stuff we see in from Kevin Sullivan. I mean, even Big Boss Man, when he comes in, it's just, you listen to those promos. Ron Wright.
Oh, Jesus Christ. But Ron could do anything at any time. But what the promos that Kevin sent in from Florida, the ones on tape where he's doing the The Shining.
Yeah.
And the fucking, he's the bartender and everything. He was shooting those in Florida at home and sending them to me.
Oh, see, we thought he may have been in Japan during that time, and that's why he wasn't. That's why he wasn't on the TV.
He had a friend of his with a camera. They come over to him, and that's when he was with Nancy. I think Nancy may have been had her back to the camera in one of them.
Okay,
his friend would shoot him at his house. He'd mail them up to me, so it cost. And next time I saw him, I'd give him $5 for postage or whatever. That was the production budget we had in that. But I let him make up whatever the fuck. He knew what we wanted him to talk about and what the match was coming up. And I said, "Just do your thing. Send whatever the fuck you want."